You better to tell us the way.
The World Serpent? Wait, do you know how to talk to him?
Indeed. He speaks an obscure tongue more ancient even than these mountains. None are left in Midgard who speak it. Except, of course, for me.
You do?
That's true. You wouldn't know it to look at him, but Jormungandr is a sparkling conversationalist.
So, Mimir, why did Freya spin your face?
No. Speak of Baldur. He claims nothing harms him.
Aye. Baldur is blessed with invulnerability to all threats, physical or magical.
Boasting of a god. Everyone has a weakness.
Not him, I'm afraid. Baldur is blessed with invulnerability to all threats, physical or magical.
You just said that, Mimir.
Did I?
What is the source of his power?
Well, as I recall, it involved, spell?
Mimir?
Parts of my brain must still be coming back to life. Just need a moment to finish waking up.
I hope he's not broken. Mimir, we're in the lake.
Perfect. Dock us near the bridge.
Ed, how do we speak to the serpent?
There's a horn on a platform at the middle point of the bridge. Take me to it.
Finally, that horn!
Good. Now put my lips to the horn.
That statue made in honor of Thor. And seeing as the World Serpent absolutely abhors the fat dauber, he was probably sick of looking at it.
But doesn't that hurt?
Well, he and Thor have a bit of an unpleasant history between them. Or they will, anyway. So I guess waking up to see it was worse than the thought of lumps of solid stone passing through his gullet. You want me to ask him?
No. Our only concern is Jotunheim.
All right, wish me luck. I've still got it, lads. He remembers me. Why, you? No. your loss. He will help you.
Echnium Fogua.
Curious.
What is it?
Oh, nothing to be concerned about.
What is he doing?
Making sure we're headed in the right direction. Listen closely now. We need two things to get us into the land of the giants. First, we need to learn the travel rune that opens realm travel to Jotunheim. Second, we need to carve that rune into the special gateway.
That one of the peak where we first met you?
Correct. Except the giants, in their infinite wisdom, saw to it that no ordinary chisel would do the job. Only the tip of a magical chisel opens that gate. Luckily, I know where it is, and it's not far.
He looked kind of mad for a moment there.
Now that, you thought I said you were friends of Odin. You'll forgive me, I've never spoken the ancient tongue sober.
Wait, look! The water's dropped even further. You can see more of the realm towers and statues. I haven't seen new places to explore along the shore.
Where is this chisel?
Find me a boat, and we'll go from there.
I can read what this says now, but it's a name. Air! Whoa! The name made it light up!
It's the name of one of the Valkyries. That's quite curious.
Ah, more of those. Good. So when we get to the boat, we can either look for that special chisel now, or go exploring for a little while. I'm happy with whatever you want to do.
Focus up, boy!
Nightmares, huh? What awful pests! That one, brother.
Which way to the chisel?
Keep rowing towards the statues of the oarsmen, then thread past between them.
Look! Keep it up!
Not yet!
be Shala.
Almost ready.
Wondered what became of him.
You know this dragon?
Yes.
Although he wasn't a dragon when I knew.
What do you mean? What was he?
A dwarf. A greedy little bugger.
Not so little anymore.
Perhaps we should keep an eye out for binding shrines and free the poor bastard. Aye, lads? Source of annoyance amongst Aesir and Vanir alike.
Then why free him?
Trust the recently liberated brother. No one deserves to be held captive like this. And a greedy little dwarf come dragon.
Thank you.
I hate ya!
Thank you. Oh! Thank you. brother! Oh!